Two is too low. It's me, 3Dog. How you kids handling post-apocalyptia today?
We interrupt our regularly scheduled program for
some news. Don't lose hope, children. Don't ever lose hope. The kid from Vault 101, the Wasteland's one true messiah, still walks among us. Just listen to this. Mr. Spotted over in Arafu, where the settlement has been hit pretty hard lately by a body gang of planetarians. But it would seem that after 101 made a little solo sojourn into the murky depths of Moresti Station, the attacks stopped. The cherry on top? He emerged a short time later with a lad named Ian West, who presumably had been taken captive in the latest raid. So what happened down there in the stinking, slinking subway tunnels? Friendly chit-chat? Or a classic case of shotgun diplomacy? In the end, I guess it doesn't really matter. Arafu is quiet once more, thanks to the efforts of the lone wanderer from Vault 101. Until next time, this is 3Dog! Oh, and you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. Now listen close for this important public service announcement. We all know the dangers of radiation, but with the right precautions, you can prevent accidental death or even, ghoulification. Keep your eyes on those Geiger counters, kids. Tick, tick, tickety means run your ass out of there, and then pop some rat away for good measure. If you do need to head into the heat, be smart. Give yourself a nice boost of rat expert.
Just hacks on anything he can get. He said over. You ain't heard nothing yet.
Watch it, will you?
Hey, Nifty America. It's me, your president, John. Gotcha! Rebuild him! How's everyone doing? Everyone ready for the Capital Wasteland's latest news? Me neither, but it's that time again. Okay, it seems the settlement of Grey Ditch has gone quiet. Residents haven't come out to trade with the caravanners, and attempts to make contact have been met with silence. So if you're out by Grey Ditch, you may want to pop in and see what's what. Thanks for listening, children! This is Three Dog, ow! and you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you. And now, some music.
Scheduled program for some news.
2 weeks. It's been 2 weeks since our boys and power those enclave bastards out of Project Purity and started that baby chugging. Now, y'all remember James, right? Father of 101? Well, Three Dog has learned that back in the day, James' wife had a dream. See, she was a scientist too. Worked on that project. You know what she wanted? The waters of life, free, clean, for any and all. God, ain't that beautiful? But even better, it's finally happened. The water is clean, and hell yeah, it's free.
Ow!
Just a little patience, children. As I speak, the Brotherhood is working with Rivet City Security to get that fresh water to the wasteland. The caravans are coming. So get your glasses ready, children. This round will be. Until next time, this is Three Dog.
Ow!
And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth.
Oh, how bad it hurts.
Oh! Now listen close for this important public service announcement. Don't be sidewise. Now, music.
That civilization is a thing for me to see.
Oh.
wasteland. This is Three Dog, ow! Coming to you loud and proud from Galaxy News Radio. Let me ask you something, children. You hungry? The kid from Vault 101, the wasteland's one true messiah, still walks among us. Just listen to this. Got some great news out of the town of Megaton. Turns out the live atomic bomb in the town center has finally been deep-sixed for good. The town sheriff, one Lucas Sims, commissioned the one, the only lone wanderer from Vault 101 to disarm the nasty nuke. And the kid delivered. Hey, nice work, 101. Next time you're in the neighborhood, pop into the studio. Old Three Dogs, Toaster's been on the fritz. Until next time, this is Three Dog, ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth, no matter how bad it hurts. And now, a super important public service announcement. Just a friendly reminder to all you would-be bigots out there, ghouls are people, too. You see, children, ghouls are simply humans who've been exposed to an ungodly amount of radiation and haven't had the good fortune to die. Sure, they may look like hideous zombies from an old monster flick, but their hearts, their souls, their tears are all very much. So please, if you meet one of the Capital Wasteland's mini ghouls, leave your prejudice at the door and your pistol in its holster. Ah, yes, one important caveat, kiddies. Those feral ghouls that prefer the dark, dank underground? They are basically mindless zombies, so kill as many as you damn well please. Now, some music.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to talk of being warm. In my heart, I have a lonely fire. And that wind blew over. I just want a mission, overall in flame. I just want to be the one. And before that mission, that would be the same. I have to go my feeling of duty.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I want a flame in your heart.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to take place down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire. And that one desire is you. And I know nobody else ain't gonna do it.
Nature.
This is Free Dog, your friendly neighborhood disc jockey. What the disc? Hell if I know, but I'm gonna keep talking anyway. News time, children. It's a question for all you faithful listeners. Have you guys and gals ever seen a tree? No, not those shriveled black things. I'm talking real trees. Brown bark, green leaves, photosynthesis, all that good stuff. Now what if I, the all-powerful Three Dog, bow wow wow, place lots of trees, that depressing sea of brown. Look, years ago, the name thanks for listening, children. This is Three Dog. And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you.